Hi everyone, this is Pre-Algebra lesson 2-4, evaluate square roots and cube roots. In this lesson, you will find square roots and cube roots of rational numbers. Let's look at solve and discuss it on page 107. Matt and his dad are building a treehouse. They buy enough flooring material to cover an area of 36 square feet. What are all possible dimensions of the floor? So let's think about all possible dimensions of the floor. Dimensions are sides. What are the sides of the floor? How long are they? What's the width? What's the height? All the dimensions that you can measure, their dimensions. Okay. So if we have an area of 36 square feet, what are possible dimensions? Which means what are the length and the width that could multiply to get the area of 36? Right, so we're thinking of numbers that have a product of 36. What are some numbers? You think about it and you can first say, oh, 36 times 1 is going to have a product of 36, right? So you can write 1 times 36. What else? Have 2 times 18, right? What else? 3 times 12 also makes 36. Can you multiply 4? Yes, 4 by 9. And 6 times 6 will be 36. Are these all possible dimensions? Yes. Okay, we can also switch, but the shorter sides are going to be called width and the longer side is going to be called length. So they're always going to be the same, okay? You can draw them too. 1 by 36.
Okay, hey, so there won't be any high school students here.
Mm-hmm.
So you are free to come with us.
Okay, and 2 by 18, 2, 4, 6, 8. Okay, 2 by 18, and 3 by 12, 1, 2, 3, by 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 3 by 12. And 4 by 9, 1, 2, 3, 4, by 9. And lastly, 6 by 6. Those are all dimensions that can make an area of 36. Okay, let's look at reasoning. Why is there only one set of dimensions for a square floor when there are more sets for a rectangular floor? Are all the dimensions reasonable? Explain. Why is there only one square and a bunch of other rectangles? Is it possible to get more than one square for an area? Right? Well, there's one square model because only 6 multiplied itself equals 36. Nothing else has the same number times the same number to make 36, right? So let's write that down. There is one square model because only 6 multiplied by itself equals 36. Okay. Also, several other pairs of factors have 36 as a product. And most pairs will result in a floor that is very long, but not wide enough to fit people. And a floor measuring 4 feet times 9 feet or 6 times 6 is reasonable. Okay, let's think about this question throughout the lesson. How do you evaluate cube roots and square roots? Example one, we're gonna evaluate cube roots to solve problems. Let's read the problem. Leah is building a birdhouse for purple martins. Birds that prefer cube-shaped birdhouses. What are the dimensions of each square piece of wood Leah needs to build the 216 cubic inch birdhouse? Okay, so they prefer cubic houses, right? And we want to build the 216 cubic inch, that's the volume, not the area, birdhouse. Okay, square dimension would be areas, and cubic dimensions are describing volumes. Okay, so first think about what do you know about the length, width, and height of the birdhouse. First, draw and label a cube to represent the birdhouse. Okay, and the volume is 216 square inches. And you know that a side times the same side times the same measure of side would equal to 216 cubic inches, okay? So that is called a perfect cube. A number that is a cube of an integer is a perfect cube. The number 216 is also a perfect cube, okay? To find the value of s, you find the cube root of 216. Cube root of a number is a number whose cube is equal to that number, okay? So cube root will be notated this way. Cube root of a number is equal to n times n times n, where n times, wait, cube root of a number is equal to a number n, where n is equal to, where m is equal to a number, another number x times another number x and another number x. They should be equal to each other. Let me say that again. Where m is equal to a number n times the same number n, okay? So n cubed will be m. So cube root of m is equal to n. That is the root. That is one side. Okay, so if we look at 216, the same number 6 times 6 times 6 will equal to 216, right? 6 times 6 is 36. 36 times 6 is 216. So the dimensions of each square piece of wood are 6 inches by 6 inches. Let's look at the triangle. Question. A cube-shaped art sculpture has a volume of 64 cubic feet. What is the length of each edge of the cube? Okay, so let's fill in the blanks on the right first, and then we're going to write the answer here. The length of each edge is blank feet. Think about the cube root of 64. Which number multiplies 3 times by itself to make 64? Remember, 6 times 6 times 6 is 216. So you're going to get a number smaller than 6. So yes, 4 times 4 times 4 will be 64. 4 times 4 is 16. 16 times 4 is 64. So you can say 4 cubed is going to be 64. And that's equal to cube root of 64. Which is just 4. So the length of each edge is 4 feet. How can you find the cube root of 64? Well, how? You can choose a number and cube it to find whether the product equals 64. For example, 3 times 3 times 3 is equal to 27. And 27 is too low compared to 64. So you increase your guess and say 5 times 5 times 5 is equal to 125, but that's too high. So it must be 4, right? 4 times 4 times 4 is 64. Okay. Let's look at the next page, page 109, example 2. Evaluate perfect squares and perfect cubes. Let's look at parts A, B, C, and D. We have cube root of 64, like we just solved, right? We already know that's 4, because 4 times 4 times 4 is 64. Square root of 100. Notice if you don't have a number, that is automatically a square root. Okay? That is going to be 10, because 10 times 10 is equal to 100. And you only multiply the number twice to get that number inside your square root, right? Same thing for 49, square root 49. 7 times 7 would be 49. And cube root 8, I think that's a typo, 7 times 7, right? Cube root 8 would be a number times a number times a number, 3 times. And that's 2 times 2 times 2. 2 makes 8 when it's multiplied 3 times. Let's try problems A, B, C, and D. Which number will make the number inside your cubic root or square root? By multiplying it twice or 3 times. Okay. Should we check the answer? For 27, you need to multiply the number 3 times. And 3 times 3 times 3 is equal to 27. So cube root of 3 cube is going to equal 3. Okay. Part B, square root of 25. You need to find a number that multiplies twice to get 25. And you know that's going to be 5 times 5. And so square root 25 is equivalent to square root 5 squared. And the square and square root cancel each other out. That is 5. Okay? Square root 81, same thing. Square root 9 squared. And that is 9. Cubic root of 1, you need to multiply the number 3 times. And so you have cubic root of 1 cube, and the cubes cancel each other out and you get 1. Okay, let's look at example 3. Evaluate square roots to solve problems. Okay, Sean cuts one sheet of colorful poster paper to cover the bulletin board exactly. What are the dimensions of the poster paper? And the area of the poster paper, area of the board is 144 inches square. And so you're going to find the square root of the area to find the side lengths of the bulletin board. So that is going to be square root of 144, which is going to be 12, because 12 times 12 is equal to 144. Okay? So you need to know how to find the square root of a number and square a number so that you figure out the inverse operation of it. Let's try the try question over here. Emily wants to buy a tablecloth to cover a square card table. She knows that the tabletop has an area of 9 square feet. What are the minimum dimensions of the tablecloth Emily needs? So the tablecloth could be bigger, but it can't be smaller than the area of the table because it's not going to cover everything, right? So what's the minimum area that's exactly going to fit in there? So take the square root of 9. Well, the number 3 is going to be multiplied twice to get number 9. And so square root 9 would be 3. 3 times 3 would be 9. So Emily should buy a tablecloth that measures at least 3 feet by 3 feet. Okay, so let's summarize our lesson. The key concept we looked at today is the cube root and the square root. The cube root of a number is a number whose cube is equal to that number. Okay, cubing a number and taking the cube root of the number are inverse operations. It means they cancel each other out. The square root of a number is a number whose square is equal to that number. So squaring a number and taking the square root of a number are inverse operations. That was the end of lesson 2-4. And now you should be able to find square roots and cube roots of rational numbers.